And right now we're going into one of the nicest mansions here in Savannah, Georgia, also known as, I hear it's really popping place. Hey babe, how you doing? Gotta get some essentials. Babe, you can get some souvenirs here as well. Why go to overpriced gift shops? You gotta give some to the box stores, right? I'm so happy to see plastic bags again. New Yorkers have
these smart.
Pizza. Oh, they're smart, you're saying? Okay.
Yeah.
I don't know, but I kinda like my plastic bags.
You can't, plastic does not, what is it there? Dissolve 100%.
Oh, doesn't it? Yeah, okay. Well, we got the good stuff, I think. Pretty good.
Check out the most famous park in Savannah, Georgia. Plantation. See how bad the traffic is here. Bugging and packed. Warm, slow, 1913.
We decided to pull over to take some selfies in the prime spot here, as you can see. Absolutely beautiful. The weather couldn't be any nicer. Hey, Ma.
Hi. I just want to check one more.
Here we go. We pulled over, took a few snapshots.
Oh, my hair is blowing in the wind.
I can put the seatbelt on. Otherwise, this car will start bugging out on me. I think we're almost at the end of the road. That's where everyone's hiding out. That's the parking spot they were talking about. That's okay. We'll park somewhere. That's the... I think that's... That's where the house is. The oldest structure in Savannah. Go check it out. So I do believe this park is about 500 acres, and so you're gonna go find the ruins, check them out, and I have my hiking outfit on. Perfect. So ready to get sweaty. Let's do this. The Wormslaw Historic Site was once the colonial estate of Carpenter Noble Jones, came to Georgia with James, and I think his last name is Oglethorpe, back in 1733. This former plantation is the site of the oldest standing structure in Savannah, as I mentioned earlier. The ruins of Jones Tabby House was built in 1745. Noble Jones took several roles in the colony and fought against the Spanish. The land stayed with Jones until he died and continued with his decades until the state took over. Let's go check it out. Yeah, that's very majestic looking. With the Spanish moss, or moss, however you pronounce it. That's it right there. And this house was protected by a gate. And it was all built by slaves. Let's see what this has to say. This talks about the Spanish moss. Let's keep on looking. Period. Literally stepping back into history over here. You hear the birds chirping. You hear me puffing and huffing.
Tabby house.
Yep, there it goes. See, it was surrounded by a giant gate. 500 acres on this plot of land. Glad we came here. A window. And all that back there is a swamp, swampland. Now we're gonna go to the historic district of Savannah.
This.
Oh, it's a gallery. People enjoying picnicking on a beautiful day. It feels like. It's a big restaurant over here. And the playground. People enjoying this beautiful day. This is one of the big spots, one of the main spots, the heart of Savannah, I would say, this park right here. Fort Sith Park is what it's called, and it was in the 1840s. William Brown Hutchins conceived the idea of selling the site. There you go, a little history for you all. That's the main attraction.
Cats were playing with the lightsabers.
Mm-hmm. They made jewelry.
Why is it in
No, we gotta make a left. You just wanna see that monument? That's what I'm doing, man. Gotta work up an appetite. Playing volleyball out there. It's a pretty nice sized park. I mean, it really doesn't compare to Central Park in New York City, but well, that's what we do. We compare things to what we know. Well, honestly, as far as beauty goes, this is with those live oak trees. It's hard to compare. Yeah. Check out the monument. Lafayette Mecklos, Major General Confederate State Army. Can't see it because of the sun, but nice. We are entering the Bonaventure Cemetery. It's about 4:16. I think they close at 5.
Stop.
Find a parking spot. We can go exploring. I'm definitely glad we made it. This was definitely a place we wanted to explore. Not so originally, this cemetery was a privately owned cemetery back in 1846. And it
bought by the city of Savannah, the four cemeteries that the city were nearly full. So they bought it and then they changed it, I think, to the 70 original acres to 103 acres. And it was called the Victory. Which means what? Good fortune.
Bonneview, good fortune in French. There's a few famous folks buried here, one of which is a little girl named Grace.
Gracie Watson.
Gracie Watson, yes. And
I think on the website it said it was in plot E98.
And it feels like we're the only ones in here right now. I guess when this was a private cemetery, it consisted of 60 acres, but when the city bought the cemetery, they added land to about 160 acres.
The cemetery was owned by John Warren.
Mm-hmm.
And he was a
I don't think we'll be walking 100 plus acres today, but we definitely will get a feel for the place with the oaks and the Spanish moss that it's known for. Probably birds, maybe. I'd be curious to know though. But yeah, if you look around, there's not a soul to be found. Okay, there's a soul over there, but
Roman.
Okay, the jokes, the bad, terrible jokes. I'm gonna end it on that. Jenkins. This is definitely not your average cemetery.
In this cemetery, like history thing, it said that they put rocks on their put rocks as a form of what? Like respect and honor? Because it lasts longer than flowers, but I don't see any rocks like on top of the graves.
Yep. So our goal is to see the Gracie gravesite and it's section E. So we're heading the right way. Yes, it's very beautiful here. It's a little chilly.
Yeah, that's the guy who bought it. That's his last name anyway.
And of course, this is the cemetery's famous for the book and the movie, The Garden of Good and Evil. The movie, yes, which I strongly recommend. We are making it to the gravesite. And what's the number here, babe? E96. Oh, it'll tell us. Yep, so here's the famous gravesite. A little girl who was loved by many. Her parents were heartbroken. What was the cause of death?
Pneumonia.
Yep. I think she was 4 years old,
huh? Yeah, people left her little gifts and candies and money, and there's the rocks.
The family owned, well, let's read what it says. Little Gracie Watson was born in 1883, the only child of her parents. Her father was manager of the Pulaski House, one of Savannah's leading hotels, where the beautiful and charming little girl was favorite with the guests. 2 days before Easter, in April of 1889, Gracie died of pneumonia at the age of 6 in 1890, when the rising sculptor John Waltz moved to Savannah. He carved from a photograph this life-sized, delicately detailed marble statue, which for almost a century has captured the interest of all passerbyers. There you go. That's sad. I would not mind spending a night here with an EVP scanner to do a little ghost hunting. Probably shit my pants, but hey, it would definitely be worth it. Definitely a very spooky place at night. Would you spend the night here by yourself? Sure. She says that now.
These bugs are bad.
The bugs here are pretty bad. I'm not sure what kind of bugs these are.
They're
not New York.
Little black flies. Those little bugs that sting.
Upchurch.
Oh, that's a really cool stone.
Mm-hmm. Piano.
Musicians.
Yep. Can we step up here?
Don't you dare.
Doris Smith Upchurch. But the nature here, look at that vine just growing out of the ground into this ginormous oak tree. It's got to be a few hundred years old. Look at this bush over here. There's Spanish moss just about on anything here. It's a rose, Now, I'm not sure what kind of plants these are. Kind of flowers. Very pretty, though. We'll carry on. I would probably recommend doing a ghost tour here. I'm sure they do those during the day, which is probably not as much fun, but just to get some more knowledge, definitely be worth it.
They do tours here. Mm-hmm. They do ghost tours.
I'm they sure do they
do. On a first come, first served basis. They don't do reservations. And I don't know when the last one is, but I know they close at 5.
Right. So you can see some of the Jewish graves here. Tradition is to put rocks on top of the grave. Yeah, look at that.
It's very loved.
Yeah. 1973 to 1997. So that gentleman was very young when he passed.